Okay, in this video we're going to talk about restraints and chokes, and we're going to talk about one of the most common. It's actually in our 10 most common section on this website, the front choke. This. It'll be done by someone bigger or more powerful than us, because otherwise there's no point. I mean, I probably wouldn't even do it to Nigel. He's probably maybe a bit stronger than me. Maybe he's bigger than me, so to submit him would be a real 50-50, maybe 60-40 in his favour. A couple of things I want to just talk about very quickly is whether the hands are stacked or not, or if the thumbs are in the front, it makes no odds. Okay? And the first thing we do normally on a front choke is we resist push. We resist into it, and in fact choke ourselves. Whereas if you push, if we go this way, I know it's not ideal because we're moving backwards, but if we take a couple of steps, the pressure, there's no pressure on the back of our neck, it's on the front of our neck where the windpipe is. We have blood that goes either side of our neck to our brains, and oxygen through the blood and oxygen through the windpipe one way. So this is the most uncomfortable bit. So this is the attack. I will show you the defense. Again. And again. Let's break this down. And it's a little thing I did there was, we don't let an attacker approach us choking, okay? I wanted my hands to be down here because we were in close proximity. So this was a kind of surprise attack, like in a bar, and he puts on, whoa, this is the motion, okay? Let's do one more fast. Okay, let's break this down. Where's the threat? Exactly, on my phone. 6 seconds, maybe 8, you're passed out. There's another problem here. Is I have to stabilize. Okay? Push. Even if I have to take 2 steps, I have to stabilize. Okay? Most attacks will have some sort of pushing. Because if they don't, there's no force generated on the attack. I'm kind of grabbing, but if I push, suddenly much more comfortable, right? When I push. It's very important what foot goes back in relation to what hand does the defense. Okay? From here, we're going to stabilize, hands are up. We're going to stabilize and put our left leg back, and this arm's going to come all the way over and keep turning. The body, the defense, the latissimus muscles will remove the hands. He can't hold on. My body is stronger than his arms. From here, we're going to hammer mid, short, mid, long, long. We can go through all your techniques. We don't really have shorts, it wouldn't be a bent arm. I see this a lot. People tell me to come down on the arm. There's no need. My body is stronger than his arms. And this is why traditional martial art front chokes don't work. Nigel, please put it on touch camera, attack, let go. They teach you to do this. Okay? Let go. Hustle. I'm not strong enough because this attacker's going to be stronger than me. And secondly, when the choke comes on, my hands will come to where the threat is. 100% threat is on my throat. So why on God's green earth would I want to drop my arms? Another second gone. I'm down to 3 seconds. This guy's stronger than me. We work from here. Natural reaction, stabilize. Hand comes up close to our head and we just turn. When we get to as far as we feel this, we come back with a hammer fist, medium long in this case, and kick. Guys, really, really important here. We have to get this off our throat. Okay? The pressure is here, not on the side of the neck so much. Okay? My arms will not be stronger than his. Because the attack's very unlikely. I'm probably going to struggle to pull. I'm going to turn, use my whole body to turn. And then hammer. counter as soon as possible, get out channel and scan for second attackers. Okay? Now, a little nuance I just want to add to this is, and this is a technique that hasn't changed since Emmy invented it, but the technique used to be this, arm up. And the dynamics work exactly the same. The problem is, if you're on the tube or in a low ceiling park, like the ones we have local to us, you know the ones I'm talking about, the problem is, it could hinder my body defense. So I like to keep the head close, the arm across the head and head and arm close. From here, one, boom, 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 and out. Thank you, Nigel. So one more time, no one, from here, depending on what foot goes back, here, 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 and here. If it's the left foot goes back, here, 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 and here. And I'll just show you how it works when we're being pushed, because this works static and being pushed. Then when Emmy invented this, this technique actually was to when we're being pushed. We didn't do it before on static, but push. What you can see with Nigel then, and I stopped the counter because I knew what was going to happen, he's moving towards me using me as a gauge. As soon as I release that grip, he continues to fall. Lean on me, I'll catch you, lean on me. This will happen, see? So he actually falls into the counter. Two forces colliding, you're throwing the big punch, the big elbow, big hammer. It will certainly break the thought process. So this is front choke defense. Us. So in this video, we're going to talk about what happens when someone put this choke on. Okay? This, not this, this is restraint. We talk about this a lot. This is to pull someone away. But if someone puts this on, well, they know what they're doing. 6 seconds. Not even that. Okay? We have techniques. We have techniques where we try and pull this down and do stuff like this. If someone put this on you, what will they be?
Bigger and stronger.
Bigger and stronger. I'm struggling to do it to Moorish. Just because of the height thing. You can see. Now I can, of course, I can. I can go high, bring it down to my level. But this person's very strong, and the more he, it's like a boa constrictor. They're going to restrict and put pressure on both parts of the neck that takes the blood to your brain and the windpipe. So there's no out here. Okay? So this is a very, very serious threat, okay? Because after that you have no control. It's not about being on the floor fighting, you have nothing. Okay. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna explain this one first. We're gonna do a throw. Okay? We're gonna make change their thought process by then going to the floor. No one will be able to stop. Yes, in MMA and UFC, of course they will. Because they know it's a nice padded floor, they know they're used for this, they know they can hold on, they're gonna fight from the floor. In real life, this person is doing this, basically to submit you, to choke you out, to do either a sexual assault, mugging, kidnap, or worse. I'm minding my business. Might be an argument, I might be arguing with you and I might back into the guy. Puts it on. And one more time. Let's do it from this angle here. Right. As it comes on, you have to react. Okay? When we do it slow, you'll see the dynamics of it. Okay, as it comes on, mind my business. Stay away from me, stay. Very good break. Give them a clap for the break. So very good. Okay. Slow motion. The threat is here. The only place I can get my hand, put your hand on your bicep. Yeah, hold it yourself. Now, guys, there might be a variation here. Okay? There you go. Suzanne, come here, Suzanne. There's a load of variations. This is not one type of attack straight to the camera. This is the most common. Tap it out, right? Mm-hmm. But if someone really knows what they're doing, they will hold their shirt here. And they will scissor. It's a scissor. This actually up here
leaves a lot of space here, you've got a bit of room. This is just 100% focused on Suzanne's neck. Nothing else. Every side, everything. From here, I'm literally just pushing her. I'm pushing her into the thing. Be very careful in training. Tap immediately, double tap means release, stop whatever you're doing. Don't tap the floor, because they won't know. I've seen a karate video where he's putting on a showing the sleeper hold, and the guy's tapping the floor and he don't realize because he can't beat it, and he passes out. Guys, very good things. We talked to the kids about this at the kids' club. No one has the right, your parents, your teachers, your instructors, unless you're permission, you're doing choked, to touch your throat. No. And I say this to the parents, so you have no right to, not that we have parents that change the thing. Okay, so from here, as it comes on, the only good thing about me being smaller is it will mean the momentum he will go over me. Okay? So from here, I'm trying to get on my hands to come to the fret, 100% of the fret. Okay? I'm just going to curl into a ball as slow as I can and let him go over my back. Okay? There is a possibility that he will hold on and pull you to the floor. From here, just smash. Drop elbows, punches, hit the groin, hammers, whatever it takes to get away. Because as he's falling, his thought process would be not to go to the floor, to try and stop the other when we fall down the stairs, we try and hold on the banisters. Okay, one more time to slow it for, do it quite fast as it comes on. And move away. Okay, so as the choke comes on, no problem at all, I don't need to teach you to go to where this is. If you get any give and get your chin underneath here, happy days. But you're getting this on. So your hands come in here. Also, not just to try, because it's natural, but to try and get some leverage, okay? You have to drop your weight, because we want to go very small and let natural momentum go over, okay? If you have to go all the way down to your knees, so it's almost a hip throw. Those of you who've done judo before, it's a hip throw. You have to throw them over your hip. So those of you who ski, this is perfect. I know you're rich, so you'll ski. We didn't know what a ski was in Ealing growing up. As it comes on. From here, drop your weight, okay? Turn your knee in and stick your bum out. And they're gonna go over your lower back. The more you pull, the more they go down. Guys, it's a bit like pulling a rope over your shoulder. Okay, that's a very good analogy. Pulling the rope, you have to pull from up, top right, down to bottom left. I'm very short, so I don't need to go all the way down. But some of you might be evenly matched. Me and Rishi, he's got about a good few inches on height on me. So I'm okay, I don't need it. But the lower you go, the more dynamic the pull. So in slow motion, here. Rishi, put it on. Yeah, it's a big pull, this motion, okay? Putting two pieces of rope over your shoulder like this, okay? Like they do on that show, the crap show, Arctic Bering Sea, when they're doing all the rope over their shoulders. Same thing, from here, but you're pulling this way. The lower you go, the better. Now, I'm not gonna say you have to go right the way down to here. You might have back problems, you might have knee problems, you might be 75 years old, you might just not be physically able to. So the motion, they have to. If you don't stick your hip out, they're going to go round you. Now, of course, if you've done judo, you can do it to leg sweep. Not that I've sitting on judo, but I know this technique. The reason I prefer you not to is I want you to be as stable as possible. So you take one leg off the floor, you come over flamingo. Drop your weight. Turn down to this knee, this ankle, all the way down. As low as you need to go. As soon as you feel you're going, step out. One more time, Mishmas. Go. So, we're going to talk about straight punch defense now. Straight punch is normally a right cross phone with dominant hand if you're right-handed, or a left cross phone with dominant hand if you're left-handed. Very powerful punch, it's our knockout rhythm. I also call it a coward's punch because sometimes it comes from the side, which is very dangerous because your jaw moves up and down, not sideways.
and anyone punching people from the side is a coward's thing. Okay, so I'll show you the attack. The attack is this, please. Bomb. From here or from the side, bomb. Of course, we've got the knockout points on the side of our faces in previous videos, refer to them. Where are they? Temple, jawline, neck, and obviously behind the back of the head. And then the same left side equals 7. Okay, let's show the technique, Nigel. I'll be in 7 passive stance because it's a threat and it's not escalating. If this person is already being really aggressive, I will just punch. Okay, Nigel. Okay, go. And again, please. Okay. Let's break this down a little bit and go through the dynamics of the technique. First and foremost, where's the threat? Threat's the punch. 100% focus on this threat. None of this, slow motion, please, Nigel. None of this that we all do, I do sometimes to show off to a new student, not applicable, not actually doable. Okay? From here, we want to move out the line. Body defense, 100%. 100%. If my hands are occupied, restrained, or just too low, the punch can come in, at least I'm moving out. Which is very natural to move out the way of anything that's going to harm us. Secondly, because we're in semi-passive stance, because we've identified it as a threat, we're trying to calm the situation down, we use hand defense. So hand defense, body defense. And we're aiming for the wrist. Lucky, that was quick. That's fine. Because if I miss with my body defense isn't particularly good, for example, my hand defense is there. It's a 200% defense dynamic. Okay, when does the technique end, Nigel?
As soon as you've...
I've dealt with the threat, 100%. I'm aiming for the wrist area. Is it a redirection, deflection, or block? It's a deflection. We're actually redirecting it, but we don't know where it's going to go. Please refer to the types of defenses we have video. Redirection is when we actually guide it down another route. So, it comes in, slow motion please, hand defense, body defense. The punch will either hit me or go to the end of its journey, and then it will retreat.
Okay.
From here I move out the channel, and I counter as soon as possible. What is the counter? Exactly, whatever. Whatever is appropriate at the time. You might fall and then counter strikes the groin. He might step. And there's no counter here because I can create space. This is not hand defense, body defense, move out the channel and punch. Hand defense, body defense, move out the channel and counter. The counter is wherever. I like to use my legs wherever possible because it means I'm at the furthest distance to my attacker. Slow motion please, Nigel. Hit the wrist, deflection, move out the channel, counter, clear the channel and scan for second attacker. One more time for the sweep, Nigel. Broken down. Semi-passive stance. Chin down, hands up, arms up 45 degrees. Sorry, 90 degrees or 45 degrees in relation to the floor. Okay, weight is 50-50, so I can move both ways, so I can change direction. Hand defense and body defense. Step out the channel and counter. Scan when safe to do so. That straight punch defense. Hope it's been helpful. Go away, guys, and try it on your own. Circular 360 strikes. We've done when we see it at its earliest and we can 90 degrees absorb the hit. We've done it when it's a little bit closer and we have to use our foot of our forearm or we lean forward and hit as early as possible. Again, these are what we want to be attacked with, believe it or not, because they're the longest distance. We're probably going to use come to the most of you that have ever done Krav Maga, an induction, not so much the ultras, but most of you on video would have done an introduction course. Gordon, please come here. In fact, you may have done this, and your current class may teach us. Just 360 to the head, please.
Sorry, not hard. Continue both arms. And you do this. And you do this for about 25 minutes to learn 360. I think you may have even done it at 1, 2, 3 clubs around the area. Okay, guys, 360 is the most natural defense we have, period. In the world, it's not crap for guy, it's actually common self-defense. Protect your head. This is when it's a little bit closer to proximity. The strike is a little bit closer, it could be a hook, it could be a slap. We're still protecting the side of our head and knockout points. As it comes in, we're using the bone of our arm on the, as close to the wrist as possible. A little bit of body defense. Now, this is the problem I have, and this is why we're doing this online website, to help people with this. You will see many, many, many videos of this. You'll do quite quick. Again. If you do a 50-50, we strike simultaneous. If you go on Google, you'll see a lot of pictures like this. In fact, you will find a picture of me doing it. A very nice picture, in fact, doing this with Ayal, phenomenal instructor. He created Modern Krav Maga, a very, very good man, a very, very intelligent man. But their system's not evolved. And this is why I set up Ultra. I'm not happy with asking people to do simultaneous for many, many reasons. One is it's impossible. You punch me in the face, certainly not be able to do that. Not good enough, not been training long enough, and by the time I'll be good enough, I'll be at 90 years old. Just beat me up, I'm probably ready for the grave anyway. Secondly, is this attack is with their dominant hand. The videos were done earlier about striking and earlier on the website, when they're being hit with the dominant hand, their knockout punch, rhythm number one. 100% focus, 100% anger. Okay? Relevant if they're big or smaller, this is coming. Okay? I'm theoretically asking a student, maybe Mrs. Granny Smith, 76, or Joe Block, 16, to not only split my focus on the attack and countering simultaneous, and if you look on Google, it does say Krav Maga known for simultaneous attacks. Even if I could possibly do this, I'm relying on this arm, 50%, to be enough to stop this 100% threat attack. His focus is 100% threat here, okay? What is this, by the way? Okay, let's just break this down. It's very important. What is this? Block, redirection, or deflection? A block, okay. I've already said it in the previous video. Define block. Equal or more force. Let's just do the maths. Okay, I was a C student maths. 100% focus and attack. 50% focus and defense. Equal or more force. For those of you that are statistics, statisticians or mathematicians. It doesn't add up. I have to focus 100% on this attack. Whether it's one arm or two arms, of course. Two arms is much better, whether it's the longest one, whether it's this one, but one arm, this is very natural. We're gonna use the bone. So the previous video where we used the flat part of our arm to take the energy and displace the impact, now we're using the bone. We're aiming for the wrist, as close to the wrist as possible. If we get the forearm, we're not worried, as long as we're aiming for the wrist. If we aim for the forearm, we'll be getting the elbow, and it's gonna be very problematic. I love that word, problematic. Tomasz Adamski, the Polish Krav Maga expert of United, he uses that word a lot, and I do love it. It's an important word, because we want simplicity. As the strike comes in, hand defense, body defense, aiming for the wrist, leaning inside the attack. It means if there's anything in his hand, we're out of it, become a projectile. We won't know. Guys, this is not an attack where we're in the 1950s. Okay? This is not just straight punch defense, people. No, you're doing defense. Guys, people will be punching from here. Boom! It'll be punching from all sorts of angles. It won't always be in front of you, it could be off to the side. This is our medium short. Please refer to the distance video for distance terminology. As it comes in, here. Of course, counter as soon as possible. It doesn't say punch, guys. It says counter. When does the technique end?
On the block.
When the threat's over. This journey, what does he intend? What does he think is gonna happen? is going to hit me. It will stop here. If it doesn't, it will continue on its way, and then he'll reset. Okay? That's where the technique ends. Fight as fast as you can. Go. That's the end of the technique. I've not been hit. Now it's a different attack, or a different approach, a different part of this confrontation. The other one is hit. Aiming for the elbow, aiming for the wrist, using my wrist and my bowing part of the arm. After that, what you do next is up to you. We have to break the thought process as soon as possible. But if you can escape, escape. Ideally, we want to be at our longest limb to defend. But if you have to go that way, good luck. Again. As soon as possible. If as soon as possible for you is this, if you're clever and quick, or the situation like he's really, really drunk, and you're trying to fuse it, and he throws it, and you can throw it in shattered rhythm, for rhythms, please refer to the rhythm video on this website, fine. Focus on the attack. Boom! Boom! Move. Go away, be careful, put your arm bars on if you want. Okay, let's continue talking about what happens when we're on the floor. Of course, we can go to the floor from being pushed, we can go to the floor from someone taking us down, we can go to the floor being tricked, or we can go to the floor be on the floor for leisure activity, sunbathing, reading a book in the park, having a picnic. Very, 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 very natural environment. This will normally happen if you're already there for leisure. Beach, park, as I've already said, along beside the river. So we need to make sure that we can, because we find ourselves in these situations, that we can react to these situations. Unfortunately, the most natural reaction puts us in a bit of problems, which is this. Mush is sitting on me. And he's choking or hitting, it doesn't matter what he's doing. And my natural reaction will be to bridge. This is the most natural reaction we do. Okay? Unfortunately, his natural reaction will be to stop himself falling. So his hands will go down here. And then what will probably happen is he'll sit more weight on us. And because we're fighting, we're not subdued, he will punch, elbow, headbutt. Yes, very, very bad. Okay. So we'll go from here. So I'm minding my business. The natural reaction is to bridge. Okay? So bridge and buck. Because we don't want the stranger on us. So from here, then we need to react. This is where our training will kick in, maybe after a natural reaction. Anyone sits on you and you're not used to it, so if you're not wrestling, you're not doing BJJ, you're not MMA, judo, then it's gonna get the head off me, it shouldn't be on me. They will also stop themselves from you because they want to be on you. You don't want it, they want it. To recap the bridge, because you're going to do it naturally. Get off. The side you want to roll, you come over and you hook with your forearm. My arm is not strong enough, more than likely, to be stronger than his arm. So I need to use both my arms. And what I do is I clasp. And I use the rotation of my arms and the bone of my forearm to bring this in. Bring it in, but I want to stop it going out. From here to here. With a huge bridge. Now there's a danger here that I'm quite low. So he could punch it up. So we need to break the thought process as soon as possible. He could headbutt, come back with hammers, but you need to start ground and pounding. You keep striking until he's not responsive. Then, what I like to do is hit the groin. Groin guard. Boom! You'll get a good indication how out of it he will be. If he's not responding too much from that, you're safe to disengage. If he is in the game, he won't be off that. Boom, boom, defend your face. From here, we go deep. Our forearm hooks underneath the Achilles and the calf, and we throw the whole leg over. Pressure on the hips and the shoulders. Step away and kick. Even stay there, mush go back. Even here, don't shuffle around to kick somewhere, kick wherever. Kick so hard you get the piece of skin between the bum hole and the genitals. Boom! Make sure you don't need to kick the head or the kidneys or the leg. If the leg's here, stop. Boom! Make sure they're not going to chase after you. Most times, with females, this will be a sexual assault. Thank you. Okay? This will be a sexual assault. Let's show one more from here. It might even, guys, be his hand might already be here. He could be really putting some pressure on or punching. If he's punching, of course I've got to defend. This comes across and I clasp. And I rotate and pull into myself here. I hold it tight against my body as I bridge. It doesn't matter if he even puts his hand here. The bridge, my body weight and momentum will take me to here. Smash, continue to smash, rain hammers down, doesn't matter, on the chest, solar plexus, nose, stomach, when you feel that there's time to disengage, strike the groin, come over, and kick, stand, smash, depending where your exit is. Try not to do this, because if they are, God forsake, yes, still in the game, they can hit your groin, grab your leg, okay? Thank you, Mush. So, to recap, we're going to go this way this time. Clasp. Rotate, use the bony part of your arm on and hold it into your body. Hold it tight. Huge bridge into control here. Grab that. If you land here, it's not a problem. We do what we've done on the previous videos. Foot inside the Mush, come and lay here, please. Stay down. If we land on our knees, of course we can't. They're over our head. We smash, we smash, we smash, we ground it, we smash his jingle bells to nothing. This arm stops the leg coming over. We just push here and disengage. The reason we don't push both legs, like you'll see on some clubs, is because if the legs are quite elongated, he can just put them straight. It's not a problem for him. Or straight, not a problem. If they're up here, of course, stretch the balls as wide as you want and kick to it. But by doing this, you're just opening up the gate. Stopping this coming out because we don't want this to happen. Stopping the gate, pushing away. This is the natural technique from when you've acted naturally and had attackers sit on you and you've bucked. Okay? Guys, bucking is a very, very, very good technique. It doesn't allow the attacker time to think. If you're evenly matched, bucking alone will break the thought process. It will make them think about, whoa, this isn't what I expected. But if the guy's much bigger than you, one buck, he'll sit all his weight on you. It's even harder to breathe.